We've been receiving a lot of queries from women wanting to know if they need to train differently from men, and also wanting to know why they find it a lot more difficult to get a ripped appearance compared to their male counterparts. Before we get into the video, please make sure you hit the subscribe button so that you get notified for more interesting content on our YouTube channel. To understand if your training and nutrition plans need to be different from your male counterparts, you need to understand that men and women are physiologically different. So let's look at the key differences between men and women and how these affect your nutrition and training plans for fat loss. The first key difference between men and women physiologically is in the amount of muscle mass that we have. Women tend to have only about 2/3 the muscle mass of men to begin with. Secondly, the amount of body fat percentage that women have is a lot higher compared to that of men. Thirdly, the amount of fat-free mass that women have is a lot less compared to that of men. So when you combine these three factors, you could be looking at a difference in BMR or basal metabolic rate of about 250 to 400 kilocalories between men and women. The second difference between men and women is in the way the body stores fat. The fat storage patterns are very different between men and women. Men tend to store more fat in the intra-abdominal cavity or in the abdominal area, and women tend to store more fat in the femoral and gluteal area, which is basically the hip region. The third most important factor, which is the reason why we have these basic differences in muscle mass and body fat storage patterns, is the hormone profile difference between men and women. So men tend to have more testosterone and women tend to have more estrogen and progesterone. So considering all these factors, does it make sense to have a different approach to training and nutrition in men and women? Let's look at nutrition plans. Whether you are male or female, the basic tenet of nutrition plan works on the fact that a calorie deficit will allow you to lose fat. So this doesn't change at all between men and women. If you are on a calorie deficit, whether you are male or female, you will lose fat. So you don't have to make any changes in your nutrition plans. As far as training is concerned, I would definitely say that women have a slight edge over men. First of all, women tend to recover a lot faster from their workouts compared to men. Research shows that the nutrient delivery is a lot better in female bodies compared to men. Secondly, women are more well suited for higher volume training compared to men. So if you are a woman, you can make your workout plan in such a way that you increase your volume. The volume of training can be increased comfortably if you're a woman. Thirdly, because our recovery rate is quite high, it is possible for women to train one particular muscle group more frequently throughout the week compared to men. And lastly, women can also work out with shorter rest periods or rest intervals. So even though as women we start out with a disadvantage in terms of the amount of muscle mass we have and in terms of the higher body fat levels we have, you don't have to worry too much. The best thing is for you to work with the advantages that you have in terms of training and stop focusing too much on numbers like body fat percentages.